Hello and welcome to Peeling in the Kitchen with Harriet. It's been a little minute, but I wanted to come to you and share something that I'm going to do today. It's called cooking, and come on in, check it out. Let's see what's going on. Today I think I'm going to make some cornbread. So let's go ahead and get that in the oven ASAP. You know, preparation is the longest part of cooking. The baking is not as long. With my cornbread, I'm going to use the meal and the flour mixture. A little seasoning has been added, and I'm going to add eggs and milk. Stir well. Blend well. You don't want it to be too soupy, but you don't want it lumpy either. I don't necessarily want my cornbread to rise too high. But let's get the cornbread in the oven so we can continue with my staple. You know what my staple dish is, don't you? You know what that one dish is that I love to make? My vegetable. You know it. You already know. You already know. Okay, that's mixed well. Just want to get the lumps out. And then I prepare my pans. Remember, I just said preparation is the longest part of the process. I'm going to prepare these with just a little spray. Sometimes I dust my pans, but today I'm not going to dust them. Just wanted you to see the process and the finished product. Delicious cornmeal. Okay. Now I'm going to, scallions. I'm going to save those for a little bit later. Spread it out, shear it evenly. I'm actually making two pans. You said you can't see. Oops, sorry. Because my counter and my range, my stovetop, are so far apart, not on the same plane, couldn't get right in the middle. Okay, that's going to be good enough. As you remember, I prefer cleaning as I go. You take your spoon and spread to evenly distribute in the pan so it won't be so one-sided. And one thing we prepared in advance, preheat your oven. Now you want to place this in your oven. Set your timer for 15 minutes. Today, I'm also preparing fried squash and cabbage. I want to do the fried squash first. I can see I'm getting ready for the cabbage over here. Preparing for fried squash. I like to steam my squash first. So my squash is steamed and almost a go. It's almost a go for my squash. I don't have so much going on. In case I drop something on the floor, I don't like to lose. Of course, my floor is sterilized, sanitized, all that good stuff. With the space between my counter and my range, that's what concerns me. I'm simply going to saute the boiled squash and add a little seasoning to it. Saute in butter. Unsalted butter is what I prefer using. Approximately two tablespoons. That's good enough. Okay. You want to make sure your butter is good and soft as you saute. Season as you prefer. I prefer just a little salt and a little pepper because the squash and the onion gives all the flavor and seasoning that you need. Squash is also a seasoning, did you know? You can use dried squash to season your other meats and vegetables as well. Try it, you'll love it, promise. I am also preparing okra. I just let that steam in a little broth. Whole okra, as you can see. Later, I'll prepare yams and perhaps mushrooms. Don't know if I'll do the mushrooms today, but I have them prepared. Delicious baked chicken. That you can warm again. But I didn't want to warm the cornbread. I want the cornbread to be hot. I think I'll prepare some yams. And perhaps yellow rice, but we'll see. Okay, ready for the cabbage. I'm sorry, the squash. I'm so ready to get to my staple. They smell so good. They smell delish. This is video. Someone's gonna invent the smell-yo and the taste-yo, but this is delicious. I can let you know that already. I'm a lefty, as most of you know who've been following POTV. I have my timer on my cornbread. As my squash continue, I think I'll begin my cabbage. And let's see. Yes, I think I will begin the cabbage. We'll do the rice a little later, or the mushroom. As the squash is simmering, I'll begin the cabbage, or sauteing rather. Okay, with my cabbage, I'm going to add scallions.
Okay, we're back. Sorry about that. So we're gonna have to start all over again.
Starting with my dark cabbage. Adding vegetable broth to my cabbage. I usually measure approximately a cup, but I can fill just the amount that I need. And if I use too much, I love the broth. Of course, my mother calls it, and I call it the pot liquor. So good. So as the cabbage steams, it will make more liquid. It's okay to use the same utensil for the squash and the cabbage if that's what you desire to do. Perfectly all right. Okay. Thank you. squash are good. I'm going to season them to taste. Just a little salt. I really like the unsalted butter seasoning with the squash and onions, so I really don't need too much salt or pepper, but I'll add a little, just a sprinkle. That is good. Enough seasoning there. Keep an eye on the bread, even though I put it on 15 minutes. Oh, wow. I'm glad I checked. 15 minutes. May have been a little too much. Looks great. Touch to make sure it springs back. I think 12 minutes was good. Let's add some more cabbage. Turn off the squash. Like to see the bread? I'm sure you will. Let's let you see it as I remove it. Can you see it? It's in the oven. It looks great. Delicious cornbread. And remember that it is hot. A little bit uneven. I want to baste it with butter. Unsalted butter. Allow the cornbread to sit and cool. Baked chicken. Place your chicken in the oven. Set your timer for 30 minutes. And keep an eye on it as I return more cabbage as they are steaming and boiling down. Add more cabbage. as you add the cabbage. You can also remember that you're going to place the yams in the oven as well. Washer in my favorite pot. I need two like that. So I'm going to use the same pot that I'm using for my squash for some additional cabbage because I am preparing more cabbage than usual. Place the squash. So that I can use the same nice skillet. I just wanted to see the squash, so I wanted to use a see-through container. So that you can see it's a video, not a smellio or tastio. Maybe soon there'll be a tastio and a smellio. They are delicious. Delicious. Thank you for tuning in. As I am going to place some yams in the oven as the chicken is baking as well. It's okay, these go on the bottom. Black, just fine. Okay. Preparing to add more cabbage. This is fine. Let's see how this was doing over here. Let's get another utensil for my okra. Okay, here we are. Okay, well, let's see what's going on with I'm adding scallions to my squash. I love scallions. I love scallions. Yes, I love scallions. Thank you. cabbage. I hope you like cabbage. I love cabbage. I love, love, love cabbage. I love cabbage. Love, love, love cabbage. And there's some okra as well. Some scallions and red peppers. Dash of salt. Let's add some scallions and red peppers. Yum. We're adding scallions and red peppers. Okay, well, thank you for joining in with Peeling in the Kitchen with Harriet. Have a great week. We'll see you soon.
Bye-bye. We out.